Don't drown in the waves, man.
But look, man, that is not what we own. What we own is the Pilgrim's Progress. And I can see some of the teens now like, really, Mr. Sebastian, we own that again? Yes. It's the summer progress, right? We're supposed to be growing, moving forward, because everything that's living, as you've heard me say 100 times, everything living is growing. Everything living is moving forward. Progression is a part of life. Nothing stays the same, right, except for Christ. That's the only thing that stays the same, or the only person that stays the same is Christ. So look, the first Sunday, what did we talk about? We talked about soul conviction, right? Being convicted in your heart and knowing that there's something that needs to be changed. Like, I'm headed for destruction if I stay this way. If I keep acting like this, I will never get to the goal or to the purpose that God has for me. And you feel in your heart that there's something different. You feel in your heart that it's not just all about looking fly, looking good, looking cool. It's not all about being liked, being popular, but you feel like, yo, there's a change that I need, and that change, that need for that change, that want for that change is due to a soul conviction brought on by the Spirit. And then that second Sunday, what did we talk about? Keep going, right? Like Pilgrim, right? He was a pilgrim. His name is Christian. He begins to feel the soul conviction. He tells his wife and kids he got to leave. And then what do people do? They laugh at him. Wife's laughing at him. Kids laughing at him. People come chasing him down, trying to get him to stay. But what does he do? He keeps going. And why does he keep going? Because of week number 3, because he realizes that it's worth it. It's worth it. He realizes, like, look, nothing in this world compares to what is going to be revealed to me. The glory that I'm going to see, the angels, Jesus, you feel me? The saints, Peter, Paul, the martyrs, Perpetua. Like, none of that is going to compare. None of this worldly stuff is going to compare to that. So he keeps going because he realizes it's worth it. And then the fourth Sunday, right? Don't fall for the okey-doke. Don't fall for it. Like, people are going to tell us we tripping, we crazy. That's not the rational thing, right? Believing in Christ is not rational. It doesn't make sense. Like, God came from heaven. Like, no, why would he do that? Right? Don't fall for the okey-doke. This is the life of abundance. This is the life of abundance. The devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. So what does that mean? That means he wants us to think that the world is the life of abundance. And it ain't. Christ came to give life and give it abundantly. So look, this is the fifth Sunday coming up, and I'm excited, I'm ready. Y'all already know we're going to get in that word. We're going to get into the book of the Pilgrim's Progress, talk about it, read about it, recap. We're going to play some games. We're going to be laughing at some folks. But look, we're going to leave with understanding that God is telling us right now today to enter. If you're not a Christian, he's saying enter into my family. He's saying enter into your destiny. Enter into a life that is going to be abundant. Enter into a joy, a peace that the world cannot give you. Enter into what it's like to truly be a person that is in the body of Christ, that is saved, that is being sanctified. Enter into that. And then for us that's already in the family, already in the body of Christ, he's saying, hey, you ain't reached it yet. Keep on entering. Knock and it will be open, the Bible said.